This is Raju, Assistant Professor of Chemistry, Freshman Engineering Department, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering College, Dundigal, Hyderabad. Today our topic is secondary cells. In the secondary cells, we are discuss about the introduction to secondary cells or secondary batteries. In the secondary battery, we are discussed about the lead acid cells and the nickel cadmium cells. Now coming to first point, introduction to secondary cells. These secondary cells are the rechargeable cells. In these secondary cells, reversible reaction takes place. That means reactants are converting into products, products are converting into reactants. And these cells are multiple type uses. These are rechargeable batteries which are designed to be recharged and used multiple cycles. These cells in which the cell reaction is reversed by passing direct current in opposite direction. The secondary batteries can be used through a large number of cycles of discharging and charging. These batteries have very large capacities and allowing periods of low current rate discharge. The cell reaction is reversible. The reactants are returned back to reactants. That means reactants are converting into products. Products are converting into reactants. So this is the reversible reaction. Reactants are converting into products. Products are converting into reactants. These batteries are used as source of DC power. And best example for secondary cells are lead acid cell, nickel cadmium cell, and one more is a lithium ion cells. Lithium ion cells. The classification of secondary batteries. The secondary batteries are further classified as follows. So that are lead acid battery, lithium batteries, nickel cadmium batteries, sealed maintenance free batteries. Now first one is the lead acid battery. These kinds of batteries require proper care and maintenance of lasting longer. These are used in inverters, automobiles and in backup power systems. It has to be charged for a long duration and performs good when maintained properly at regular intervals. These provides the best value of power and energy per kilowatt hour. So the lead acid batteries, these are the secondary batteries and these are mainly they are used in inverters, automobiles and backup power systems. It has a longer duration for charged and these provide a best value for power and energy per kilowatt hour. Now coming to next classification, that is lithium batteries. So this battery is used in portable devices such as, so these lithium batteries are mainly they are used in phones, music players, etc. And has capacities depends upon the size of the battery. This lithium battery capacity depends upon size of the battery. These are high density and has a potential for high capacities. Therefore, it can be used to provide high current in power tool applications. So these lithium batteries are mainly they are used in mobiles, that means phones, music players, and having this capacity will be depends upon size of the battery. Now next one, that is nickel cadmium battery. This battery can be recharged many times and has more physical and electrical withdrawing capacity. It has nickel oxy hydroxide is the cathode and cadmium is the anode, with the potassium hydroxide is the electrolyte. These batteries are used in portable computers, cam recorders, other small battery operated instruments. The nickel cadmium battery is the secondary battery. In this nickel cadmium battery, we are used the cathode is the nickel oxy hydroxide and anode is the cadmium and electrolyte is the potassium hydroxide. The batteries are portable. These batteries are mainly they are used in portable computers, camcorders, and small battery operating instruments. And one more secondary cells are sealed maintenance free batteries. These batteries required minimum maintenance and can be used in supplying consistent and low power such as UPS applications. These are used to deliver instant power or used in power deficit areas such as rural areas. These are used with appliances when you need source important information when the power goes out. So this is about the sealed maintenance free battery. Now coming to secondary battery, that is a lead acid storage cell. Lead acid storage cell. In the lead acid storage battery, how the charging reactions were observed and how the discharging reaction takes place, that we have discussed in the lead acid storage battery. This lead acid storage battery, it having the anode is the PB. Anode is the PB. And the cathode is the PbO2 plates. And in this lead acid cell, the electrolyte is the 20% of HCSO solution. In this PB plates are the negative plates and the PbO2 plates are the positive plates. These negative plates and positive plates were connected in parallel. And these both anode and cathodes are separated by insulators. Both the cathode and anodes are the separated by insulator. You see here in this diagram, so this red mark is there. Now this is the PbO2 plate, PbO2 plates, and blue is the PB plates. So PB is the negative plate and PbO2 is the positive plates. So this both electrode, these both cathode and anodes are separated by insulators. Insulators, and this whole combination, we are immersed in the 20% H2SO4. 20% H2SO4. The cell consists of a series of PB plates, negative plates, and PbO2 plates, positive plates, are connected in parallel. These plates are separated by insulators like wood, rubber, and glass fibers. This whole combination, we are immersed in the 20% H2SO4. 20% H2SO4 solution. Now, in the lead acid storage battery, anode is the PB plate, that is a negative plate, and the cathode is the PbO2 plate, that is positive plate. And electrolyte is the 20% H2SO4 we are using. When this whole combination we are immersed in the H2SO4, the battery first discharging takes place. So the discharging reactions are at anode. What is the anode here? PB. PB plate is the negative plate. PB is the anode. PB is a reaction with the SO4-2 that form as a PbSO4 plus 2 electrons. So this is the oxidation reaction. Oxidation. Why this is oxidation reaction? Why? Because losing of electron takes place. Losing of electron takes place. So that is called as oxidation reaction at anode. And at cathode, what is a cathode here? PbO2 plates. PbO2. This PbO2 is a reaction with the SO4-2 plus 4H plus plus 2 electrons that form as a PbSO4 plus 2H2O. So here, this is the reduction reaction. Why? Because gaining of electron takes place. So this is called as reduction. Overall reaction is PB plus PbO2 plus 2SO4-2 plus 4H plus form as a, here 2 electrons, 2 electrons get cancelled, that form as a 2PbSO4 plus 2H2O. These are the discharging reactions. At anode, PB is reaction with SO4-2 that form as a PbSO4. Plus 2 electrons, well, that is oxidation, losing of electron takes place, that is oxidation. at cathode, PbO2 is reaction with S4 minus 2 and 4H plus, gaining up 2 electron takes place, that form as a PbSO4 plus 2H2O. The net reaction is PB plus PbO2 plus 2SO4 minus 2 plus 4H plus, that form as a 2PbSO plus 2H2O. This is the discharging reactions. Now, the cell recharge. The cell means the which cell, lead acid cell, we are recharged. At recharge, at cathode, the PbSO4 is gaining takes place 2 electrons that form as a Pb plus SO4 minus. What we have observed this reaction in the discharging reaction at anode, Pb plus SO4 minus 2 form as a PbSO4 plus. But in the charging, that products, that in the discharging products are there, not here, the discharging products are the reactants. But this takes place at a cathode. At cathode, PbSO4 plus 2 electrons form as a Pb plus SO4 minus 2. This is the oxidation reaction. At anode, PbSO4 plus 2H2O form as a PbO2 plus SO4 minus 2 plus 4H plus 2 electrons. Therefore, the overall reaction is 2PbSO4 plus 2H2O that form as a Pb plus PbO2 plus 2SO4 minus 2 plus 4H plus. So, this is the charging reactions. The cell during the recharging at the cathode, the reduction, we observe reduction. The PbSO4 is reaction, the 2 electron that form as a Pb plus SO4 minus 2. And at anode, the oxidation reaction occurs. PbSO4 is reaction with 2 moles of water molecule, then form as a PbO2 plus SO4 minus 2 plus 4H plus 2 electron. The overall reaction is 2PbSO4 plus 2H2O that gives rise to Pb plus PbO2 plus 2SO4 minus 2 plus 4H plus electrons. So, these all are the charging and discharging reactions. The main applications of lead acid storage batteries are, these lead acid storage batteries are mainly we are used in electrical vehicles and gas engine emulsions, telephone exchanges, electrical trains and mines, laboratories, hospitals and colleges and power stations, etc. These all are the applications of lead acid storage battery. Again, this applications of lead acid storage cell is, these are used in electrical vehicles, gas engine ignition, telephone exchanges, electrical trains and mines, laboratories, hospitals and broadcasting stations, automobiles and power stations. These are all about the applications of lead acid storage cell. Now, this lead acid storage cell having the small disadvantages are there. In that, first point, in the lead acid storage battery, we are using the H2SO4 solution. So, that is 20% of H2SO4, H2SO4 we are using. So, the acid forms the fumes. That means the fumes are coming to outside from the battery. So, when the fumes are coming to outside, surrounding the battery, any iron metals, iron screws or iron nuts are there, that will undergo corrosion. That means fumes from acid solution have corrosive effect on the area surrounding the battery. So, this corrosive effect can be minimized by using the sealed cells. That means sealed batteries we are using, then this disadvantage will be minimized. And one more disadvantage about the lead acid storage battery is, if the voltage is exceeds 2.39 voltage, then the water H2O is breaks as H2 and O2. So, when the water is breaks into H2 and O2, that leads to explosion. And the cell has a, one more disadvantage is a cell has low life cycle. Quick self discharging. So this lead acid storage battery having low life cycle and a quick self discharging takes place. These are the applications of disadvantages of lead acid storage cell. So you see that the corrosion effect is then these are sealed batteries. So in the sealed batteries, we are minimize the corrosion effect. And next one, next secondary cell, that is nickel cadmium cell. So in the nickel cadmium cell, anode is the cadmium and the cathode is the nickel oxyhydroxide. And electrolyte is the aqueous KOH solution. In the nickel cadmium battery, anode is the cadmium and the cathode is the nickel oxyhydroxide. Electrolyte is the aqueous KOH. So once you see the diagram, so this is the positive terminal and here in this middle is there, no? This middle is the cadmium CD anode and this is the nickel oxyhydroxide is the cathode and these are the separator. This is the separator. Now this is the construction about the nickel cadmium cell. In this nickel cadmium cell, again same cadmium and nickel oxyhydroxide plates are there connected in parallel. And these whole combination we are dipping in the aqueous KOH solution. Then charging and discharging reactions we are observed. So that charging and discharging reactions are in the nickel cadmium cell, anode is the negative plate and cathode is the nickel oxyhydroxide, that is a positive plate, and electrolyte is the aqueous KOH. In the cell reaction during the discharging at anode, cadmium is a reaction with 2OH- that form as a CdOH taken twice plus 2 electrons. So this is the oxidation reaction. At anode, cadmium is reaction with 2 moles of OH- that form as a CdOH taken twice plus 2 electrons. At anode, nickel oxyhydroxide is a reaction with 2 moles of water plus gaining of 2 electrons. So that form as a nickel hydroxide plus 2OH-. So this is the reduction reaction. The overall reaction is, so 2OH get cancelled. Here 2 electrons, 2 electron get cancelled. Therefore, the net reaction is Cd plus NiO, OH, that is nickel oxyhydroxide plus 2H2O, that form as a CdOH taken twice plus NiOH taken twice. So, this is the discharging reaction. Same, this is the secondary battery. As well as this one, again the charging takes place. In this charging, at anode, nickel oxyhydroxide is reaction with the 2OH- that form as a nickel oxyhydroxide. Nickel hydroxide is reaction with the 2OH- that form as a nickel oxyhydroxide plus 2H2O. So this is the oxidation reaction. At cathode, cadmium hydroxide gaining of electron takes place, that form as a cadmium plus 2OH. So this is the reduction reaction. The overall reaction is CdOH taken twice plus NiOH taken twice, that form as a Cd plus nickel oxyhydroxide plus H2O formation takes place. So this is the overall reaction. This is a charging reaction. The reaction can be rapidly reversed because the reaction products are CdOH taken twice and nickel OH taken twice. So this formed cadmium hydroxide and nickel hydroxides are there. Now these are adhesive to the electrode surface. Nickel cadmium battery has fairly constant voltage of 1.4 voltage. These are recently developed portable rechargeable cells. It can be left for a long period of time without any appreciable deterioration since no gas produced during charging and discharging. So these are the nickel cadmium batteries. So these nickel cadmium batteries are mainly we are used in camcorders or electrical equipments, etc. So that applications we have discussed. The applications of nickel cadmium cells are, so these are mainly we are used in calculators, digital cams and pagers. This nickel cadmium also used in laptops and tape recorders, flashlights, medical devices, electrical vehicles and space applications. And space applications, these all are the applications about the nickel cadmium cells. These nickel cadmium cells mainly we are used in calculators, digital cams, pagers, flashlights, tape recorders, laptops, space applications, electrical vehicles and medical devices. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.